Hello, I'm Greg Nichols, Science and Technology Advisor for the Homeland Defense and Security Information Analysis Center. And today we're going to be talking about smart tattoos. So smart tattoos are basically sensors that can either sit on top of the skin or can be injected into the skin like a more traditional type of tattoo. So the ones that sit on top of the skin are sometimes known as a second skin. That's basically microelectronics or nanoelectronics that are embedded in some sort of stretchable material that can sit on top of the skin. It can monitor systems of the body. It can also be used to monitor environmental conditions like toxins or something like that. If you use something that's more of a traditional type of tattoo, we usually use something which would be like an ink made of nanoparticles that can be injected just underneath the top layer of the skin. Some of these tattoos have actually been used to monitor glucose in diabetic patients. There have been some more developments in tattoos that are more permanent using carbon nanotubes that can go deeper into the skin and can act like little sensors, little needles, if you will, that can pick up glucose levels and other sorts of electrolytes like sodium in the body. These types of tattoos in the second skin can not only be used to monitor body functions, but they can also be used to identify individuals. So data could theoretically be stored on some of the smart skin technologies that sit on top, and it can be used to track people or to identify people. Obviously, some of these technologies can pose some ethical challenges and security challenges as well. So some of the things that we would be concerned about are privacy issues. As these devices, these tattoos collect data, how do we know that it's being secured? How do we know that these people aren't, basically trying to be somebody else or steal their identity? Also, the amount of data that's being transmitted from these types of sensors could be possibly overwhelming. So there would have to be some changes in the way that medical information is actually stored and collected. And finally, since these would be medical devices, they would also need FDA approval, Food and Drug Administration. So that poses some challenges too in terms of getting the right clinical trials in place and the right data and the right studies to make sure that they're safe and that they're effective. Ways that these tattoos can be used among military units would be to monitor body functions and conditions as troops are in combat, to make sure that stress levels aren't too high, also to make sure that they're not experiencing any medical conditions like heat stroke, or even if their glucose levels are too high or too low. So thanks for tuning in today. As always, you can get more information about smart sensors and tattoos from our website, hdi.org, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter.